in the Zen, zazen means Zen meditation. In Japanese, zazen is a Zen. Za is three. Zen is Zen, tranquility. So I use those terms, zazen, because zazen we do is a little different from the meditation other religions do. So that's why I want to use the original term, zazen. Za is in Chinese etymologically two persons sit in the universe. Two persons. That means sitting. That means you have to sit with more than two beings, not only human beings. You cannot sit alone. So you should sit with more than two beings in the earth, in the universe, not in the your own egoistic, selfish territory. So you must be, you must open yourself and sit in the universe. Very naturally you have to sit with all sentient beings. Okay. That is called sitting. Okay. Sitting. And then very naturally, through this sitting, that sitting is exactly Zen, tranquility. Because all sentient beings around you are exactly sitting with you. So very naturally, that is called Zen, tranquility. Tranquility. So you and the universe, earth, all beings, and all circumstances have become sitting with you together. This is called zazen, okay? So all we have to do is to do our best to sit in the universe with all sentient beings, okay? That's all we have to do. Don't expect anything special, okay? Except this. Just do your best to do this zazen. Just like a spinning on top. Top is spinning, just a spinning. At that time, top becomes still on the floor, so very naturally. So that's all you have to do is. But if you expect even slightly something from zazen, zazen becomes means, okay, to end. At that time, zazen and also purpose, okay. So very naturally, there is something else. So very naturally, you cannot always exactly sitting. You cannot do your best to do sitting because you expected something extra except zazen. Okay? So when you want to do zazen anyway, do your zazen. That's all we have to do. If you feel hungry and all you have to do is just eat, okay? Just eat. And then very naturally, you can, after eating, you can very naturally see, okay, something. But before you eat, anyway, you cannot expect, you know, full of stomach because you don't eat yet. All you have to do is, anyway, you have to eat. But intellectually, you have to know what is the zazen, what is the purpose, what's the meaning of zazen itself. So that's why we have to explain, okay? We have to, how to do zazen, how to eat the breakfast, how to eat the dinners and supper, etc. But when you jump intellectually, anyway, with your full function of your intellectual sense, well, and just eat. Just eat. It's not just to eat blindly. With your full attention, full kindness, then you eat. And then very naturally, you can see something else. So, that is the zazen. Okay, but usually, we always expect something before you do zazen. Okay, from the zazen, okay? Don't you think so? So obviously your mind is spinning. I zazen. What's the purpose of zazen? So if you do zazen, then you have heard something, you know, about zazen from your friends and from the books. So zazen makes you calm, so very naturally you expect calmness, you know. So when you sit in zazen, then you expect the calmness. But actually your mind is busy. It's pretty hard to find the calmness. So very, you are confused very much. So calmness or not calmness, anyway, that is an intellectual understanding, temporary. What is the zazen? What is the purpose? What do you mean? It's there. Why we have to do it? Many reasons there, okay? But when you start to do zazen, anyway, forget those explanations. Just that. Okay. There are 3 points. We have to follow. Harmony in body, harmonizing body, okay? Harmonizing mind, harmonizing of breath, okay? 3 points in zazen. So, let me show first how to do zazen. And then, a little bit I will explain after that, okay? So first, put your hand palm up or on your knee. And, excuse me, for this, we use this sound cushion, okay, round cushion. If you don't use the round cushion, very naturally, center of the gravity is around the hip. So if you fall to sleep, you fall down, like this, because this posture is very unstable. If you sit like this, it seems to be comfortable, but it's not comfortable as a whole, because you're oppressed, you oppress your intestines, so your intestine doesn't work, you know. And also your heart is oppressed, so you cannot breathe well. And also if you cannot breathe well, then very naturally your nerve is become irritating and the hormones cannot keep balance. So very naturally, as a whole, you become irritated, so you can't sit for long. So even though you don't feel uncomfortable sitting straight, well, this is pretty good for us. Stretch your, because if you stretch your back and the front and the very naturally, all organs operate very well. So we use this cushion. If you use this cushion, very naturally this doesn't form a three-dimensional triangle, okay? And then the center of the gravity is right in the middle of this triangle. So very stable. It makes your posture stable very much. So even though you fall to sleep, it doesn't say you cannot fall. So just like this. So while you do that, then you can speak and sleep well. Very much. Just like this. So, that's why we do this posture, okay? And also, two postures. There are two postures. Half lotus, this is half lotus, okay? Or vice versa. Your left leg on the right side. This is half lotus. And also, full lotus is like this, okay? Your both legs up on your knee. Okay. And then, if you do this posture, your weight is put on the 3 points, two knees and hip. Two knees on the square cushion and the hip on the round cushion. So this is the posture. And then next, a posture. So posture is very important. Next, put your hand palm upward on your knee. And then take deep breath. Open your mouth just slightly. Inhale, let the breath in through your mouth. And when you inhale, your body is arching backwards a little bit, you know, stretching the front. And then very slowly, with the full attention, okay? And then when you exhale, your body is arching forward, just like pushing the, taking away all inhaled breath from the lower abdomen, just arching forward. Do you understand? Do you understand? Okay? Okay, let's repeat this one. Okay, and then next, lean to the right as you exhale, and stretching out the left side of your body, and bring your body back to the center as you inhale, and exhale to the, leaning to the left, stretching out the right side of your body. And inhale and bring it back to the center. Let's repeat this swinging. And motion goes from large to small, large one to small. This is very important practice before you sit. Okay, before you sit, this is a preparation for your sitting, physically and mentally. Okay, and then the next, your left hand palm upward is placed on your right palm, and the thumbs just touch each other. Thumb just touch each other right above your middle finger, not forward or not backward, right above the middle finger, making a form of ellipse, not circle, not square, that is, okay. Not square, not circle, the form of ellipse. Not losing a sense of loose feeling, not tense, okay? A very soft, gentle the form you should make, okay? This is called cosmic universe. Cosmic mudra. Okay, mudra. So this is symbol of the cosmic mudra, cosmic universe. We cannot exist without universe, so we should appreciate universe. To appreciate the universe means that you should do something with the universe, okay? Physically and mentally. So, why don't you show universe? But the universe is big. But we can know characteristic of universe to unify two beings together, okay? In peace, in harmony. So that's why two hands put together like this. Okay. And this is the universe. So if you believe this one, if you believe this symbol of the universe made by your hand, well, that symbol really works. But if you don't believe, symbol is just a symbol. It doesn't work in you. Just like an American flag. Just like American flag. If you see the American flag, you stand up and you do this. And then symbol of American flag, anyway, works with you. Do you understand? Same apply to this. This is a symbol, but a symbol is not symbol. Symbol is something which should arrive in you. When you make it alive, when you use it, okay? At that time, symbol really has the works, really works. But a symbol itself doesn't have any sense, okay? Any sense. So only when you use it, it really works. So, anyway, that's why we make a universe with two hands. And then the universe must be one with you, with the center of the gravity. So that center of the gravity is always lower abdomen. Okay? So this universe must be touched to the lower abdomen. Okay, and then thumb's the place a few inches below the navel, not too high, not too low. Okay. Anyway. Okay, and your arms go forward a little bit, not too much like this, not touch to the side of your body. So go real forward. Just like holding the raw eggs under your arm. Neither crush nor drop, okay? Then very naturally your arms become relaxed. Okay. So next, in the lower back, push it forward, little hard, and then little adjust. This practice is little hard for you because you have never done before. So if you do the zen like this, the next day you have a sore back. You are alive, anyway. And your body, your mind, working very normally. So don't worry about it. So push, low back first, and little adjust. And straight your back, and upper back, and your head. And keep your neck in parallel with the wall first. And then, without moving your neck, pull your chin in. And such as you feel like pushing the ceiling with the top of the back of the head. And then very naturally your back become taut. Just like sticking a straight stick from the top of the head to the bottom. Okay? And then, very naturally, your eyes cast on the floor and looking at a certain point on the floor, little wider area. Don't pick up a stain from the floor. Okay. Just cast down your eyes. And then this area is almost in the same distance as your height. Sitting height. So very natural, your eyes open just slightly. Not wide, not closed. Okay. If you close the eyes, you really enjoy innate visualizations. Okay. So same to you, create same troubles. So if you open your eyes too much, that is also trouble. Your mind scatters. So not wide open, not close, but in the beginning of the zen, if it is difficult to take care of your mind, at that time you can close the eyes for a while. Okay, for a while. So, and then as soon as possible, you should open your eyes. Okay. So let's look for this posture and cast on your eyes on the floor. Your eyes open just slightly. And at that time, your nose and navel in vertical line, the ears and shoulders in same straight line. Okay. That means you cannot lean forward, you cannot lean backward, you cannot lean to the right or to the left. Exactly straight up, okay. Just like a mountain. This posture really teaches us middle way, okay, exactly middle way, neither touching to the right or to the left, or regarded as two extremes ideas, okay, not to the right, to the left, not front and back, just straight in the center, okay, that means the middle way. Middle way. But middle way is not going in the middle, but we know both, all situations. And then you can walk in the middle, okay? So you have to keep your body always not tipping forward or leaning backward or leaning to the right, to the left. You have to watch, okay? You have to understand the whole situation there. Okay, and then next, close your, bring your teeth together and lips together, and also tongues should be touched to the roof of your mouth, okay, as natural as you can. Very naturally, your mouth is closed. Okay. Next, let the breath in through your nose and let it go down to the lower abdomen. And let the all inhaled breath out through your nose. Slowly. Okay, let's repeat this breathing. When you have a proper posture physically, and very naturally your breathing going in and out from your mouth, from your nose to the lower abdomen, okay? Without stopping on the way to the lower abdomen.